George Floyd death not found to be hate crime, according to Minnesota AG. That's Attorney General to you and me. I like just say AG. And the title of the video is going to be Minnesota AG says Derek Chauvin not guilty of hate crime in George Floyd murder. And there's a topic report, and the topic report is George Floyd Chauvin verdict fallout, not hate crime. And we're going to talk about more than just the hate crime thing here, because there's more angles that are unfolding. And this is one of these complicated stories. And I want to say this before I get to the first story here, or the first link that I'm going to talk about with this topic. And that is, when you look at a video, one of these cop shooting, where somebody dies or somebody's roughed up or whatever it is, where some human being experiences some level of physical alteration due to altercation with the cop. Ask yourself, when you look at that video, place yourself in that video, even more jarring, I think, place one of your dearest loved one that you have in your mind, place them in that video, and you could get to a lot more clarity, a lot more perspicacity when you put your loved one in that video and trying to figure out whether this is something that society should be okay with or not. And when I do that, when I put one of my loved ones where George Floyd was, I understand all the things that led up to it, and I wouldn't defend my loved one, some of the things that happened there. Choices made by George Floyd, bad choices made by George Floyd. But still, even with those bad choices, and I would consider all the bad choices that led up to this, I find myself enraged. I find myself, if that was my loved one, if that was my wife, because I would say my wife, my daughter, if that was my wife or my daughter in that video, blood would shoot out of my eyes. So there's that tells me, for me at least, and emotionally, emotions aren't necessarily, they shouldn't be your 100% guide, but nor should you dismiss them entirely, because emotions are a form of heuristic knowing, I believe. And there is some heuristic knowing going on there that tells me whatever the letter of the law is, whether Chauvin did this, violated the law or not, you don't want a police department that does what happened to George Floyd to roam the streets. And if you put your loved one in that place, you don't want your loved one to be in a place where George Floyd was. Now, what's happened here with this link from the Insider, this is for Yahoo News Insider, their title is Minnesota's Attorney General says there was no evidence to charge Derek Chauvin with a hate crime in the murder of George Floyd. Minnesota Attorney General, Attorney General Keith Ellison. Now, this Keith Ellison, remember, Keith Ellison is a pretty, I hate saying far left, because he's, they're really the far right left. They use all of the tactics and authoritarian moral supremacism of the far right, but they use it in alleged service to, quote unquote, leftist concerns. So when he's saying this, he told 60 Minutes in an interview aired Sunday that there was no evidence that Derek Chauvin's murder of George Floyd last May was a hate crime. When interviewer Scott Pelley asked Ellison whether the murder was a hate crime, the prosecutor replied, "I wouldn't call it that because hate crimes are crimes where there's an explicit motive and bias. We don't have any evidence that Derek Chauvin factored in George Floyd's race as he did what he did." And that might very well be true, and that probably is true. I don't think we have evidence to suggest, as far as I've seen, that Derek Chauvin is a racist, that this is a racist hate crime. But I will say that there is, I believe, a degree of there's more fear. There's more fear among cops of black people than there are white people. And that is a problem. And maybe because of their experiences, they built this up. And this isn't just amongst white cops, by the way. I believe black cops also fear black people, especially black young men. They're feared far more, I think, than most white people are. So I don't know, in the critical theory world, that would be racism, and I don't think that's racism. I think there's other reasons for that. It has to do with majority-isms, and it has to do with the way that our mind makes associations. Like, for instance, we make cause and effect connections, and we make them cause and effect. There's correlations that are not necessarily cause and effect. but we make all correlations cause and effect. So if you experience a situation where for other reasons outside of race, you have more black people that are doing more violent crimes in the area where you're policing, you tend to build up some unintended connections there, and that's something to explore. More headlines here connected to this. Well, another one from Yahoo News. This is from Axios, though. We didn't have evidence George Floyd's killing was a hate crime. And then we have some other things that are falling out as a result of this George Floyd verdict. We have Charlie Baker, Police Officer Standards Training Commission accountable, George Floyd, Derek Chauvin, MA. So I don't know what that headline actually means, but I think I do. Let's see if this actually explains it. A newly minted commission tasked with certifying and regulating law enforcement officers in Massachusetts has a long road ahead of it before members can dive into the bulk of their work, the chair of the body said Monday during a swearing-in ceremony. So this is just their swearing in. And I think that this goes to the heart of part of if Chauvin didn't actually break the law, I'm not saying whether he did or didn't. A jury found him guilty for whatever that's worth. If Chauvin did or did not break the law, if these are in fact the policies of the police, well, then the policies of the police, well, that might be a problem. Again, put your loved one in that situation and ask if you would like people that carry guns with them, that whenever they make an interaction with someone, there's a threat of violence involved, and they confront people over nonviolent crime issues, over issues that don't have to do with human beings even directly hurting one another violently or otherwise. And you have these policies in place. Do you want to live in that world? Do you want to live in a world with these kind of human beings that have this kind of power and have these types of policies that could put you in a situation where somebody can put their head on your back and neck area for 8+ minutes? That is a good thing. Pushing for votes for the George Floyd Justice in Policing Act from WSN.com. How MMA fighter Don Williams helped achieve justice for George Floyd. That's from TheGuardian.uk. I don't have time to go into that, but there it is. Biden says he wants unity. He can prove it by supporting Tim Scott on police reform. That's from DentonRook.com, and I believe Tim Scott is a conservative. Chauvin verdict looms as three ex-officers face trial in George Floyd's death from NPR. And finally, community damaged after George Floyd's murder wants to decide how it rebuilds. More than 130 businesses were damaged or destroyed, none of which should have been damaged or destroyed. Unjust. If you were part of that, I don't care if the George Floyd death was unjust. You were not just in doing what you did.